Hey, Alabama Bass Nation, it's Chris Tate, your social media director with the Alabama Bass Nation. And today I have my special guest with me is Skylar Stevens from Helena. Skylar, welcome to the Zoom presentation.
Thank you for having me.
So, you know, Skylar, I understand that you want to follow in the legacy of your uncle, who was pro angler, Cal Mayberry. So kind of tell me, about your uncle, what he's kind of taught you, or anything you want to share about Kyle.
My uncle is the one who really got me into fishing. I mean, growing up, me and my family, we didn't have a boat, but he did because he was a pro. And so I used to go fishing every now and then. I really wasn't big into fishing at the time, but he's the one that really sparked me into fishing. And he was a respiratory therapist at Children's Hospital, also while fishing professionally. So I kind of want to carry his legacy along in fishing and just helping people.
That's awesome. And I hope you succeed in those footsteps. I know your uncle was a great guy. And, we want to wish you the best success at the college level. Next thing I want to talk to you is about this Helena football team. You guys are 6-0. You guys last week played McAdory, I believe. And yes, so tell the viewers about this game. This was an awesome game, apparently.
Okay, so McAdory was one of the better teams in Alabama, and we beat them in double overtime, 41-36. It was a dogfight. They had 14 points on us early, but we didn't get our heads down. We stayed in it, and we ended up pulling out the victory.
All right. And so now this was double overtime that you guys won this. So I imagine that your coach was biting his nails the whole time. Kind of tell us, about this, the back and forth in this double overtime.
There were a lot of tension between both teams. Coach wasn't too worried about it because he knew that we would find a way to overcome that. And he just let us play. I mean, he had great calls and we executed really well and then we got the win.
That's awesome. Skylar and I know that you're this coming weekend or what, tomorrow or Saturday is your homecoming. You guys are playing Chilton County there. So we want to wish you guys the best of luck. You guys are only a couple games away from going to the state championship, I guess. So, I want to wish you the best of luck and the Helena team. Now, I see you're number 69. So what position do you play?
I play left tackle on the offensive line.
Okay. All right. Perfect. So, naturally, I want to congratulate you on being selected or your attendance to the first Bassmaster Combine. And this is kind of your first step in following, I guess, Kyle's legacy.
Yes, sir.
So, first, just give me a brief overview of who Skylar is, your academics, your fishing career, anything that you want to share with us to get, let us know who Skylar Stevens is.
So I'm kind of a busy guy. I do fishing, football, lacrosse, and I have a full-time job while in school. My grades, I would say they're pretty good. I have a 3.85 GPA.
Outstanding.
And I'm fortunate enough to where I'm able to stay on top of all these priorities that I have and execute them fairly well.
Okay. So kind of tell me about your fishing career. I don't know what trails you fish. I know you fish the Alabama Bass Nation Trail. I don't know if you fish any other trails or anything other than that.
This year, we're only doing Bass Nation. We're really focused on Bass Nation because you can go to nationals and everything. We did airport in the past along with Bass Nation. We've done Bass Nation every year. I've started fishing in eighth grade, so I've been doing it for 5 years. we went to Nationals last year, which was really fun. That was the first time we ever went to Nationals. Just good.
Okay. So when you're looking at the Bassmaster Combine, what are you hoping to get out of the Bassmaster Combine? What are your expectations?
I'm expecting for the competition, like everybody, all the other kids there that are going to be really, really well. Some are probably going to be better than me. And just the competition of it's going to be really fun. I'm expecting to learn a lot, getting to know people, because I love meeting new people, getting to know people. And I feel like I might meet some people who will help me better myself in some fields that I'm not so good at. So.
All right. And so, have you decided on any major that you want to do in college or anything specific you want to study?
I'm thinking about going into some sort of medicine or becoming a nurse or teaching. They're both very different. I want to do something where I can help people. Okay. And be able to help better somebody in any way possible. Because I love meeting new people, helping people. That's just who I am.
Okay. So, if you are you're sitting in front of me as a college recruiter, and I'm looking to bring you onto my team, what assets and leadership traits would you bring to my team?
I would bring the will to not quit. I get whenever, if I go to college as a freshman, I'm not going to be one of the main guys, if that makes sense, because you got all those other seniors who've been there forever. But it's all about waiting your turn for your moments. I mean, when I was a freshman and I came up to football, I knew I wasn't going to start, but I just kept grinding it. And finally, as a senior, I'm starting on the football team. So it's just all about waiting your turn and just keep grinding and learning as much as you can, so that way you can better yourself and better the people around you. I like to say I'm a hard worker. I mean, if I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it all the way, pedal to the metal. I don't want to do something and half do it. So, like fishing, football, all that, I love doing it. So, I do it to the best of my ability at all times.
Okay. So, say I'm a college recruiter again. What would you do? What would you tell me? Say, hey, I need to bring Skylar Stevens on my team. He's the main guy that I need to have. Tell me how you would approach that, or tell me how you would sell that.
I would tell you all the stuff I know about fishing. I mean, I know all the stuff I know how to do. I know how to fish shallow. I know how to fish deep. I know how to read graphs. I can run a boat. Just all the stuff I can do that some people might not be so good at. Like, some guys are better at shallow. Some guys are better at deep. I can do both.
Okay.
As opposed to them.
All right. So you're a pretty versatile fisherman. What preparations have you been making for the combine, in October?
I've been practicing like my knot tying and stuff like that, making sure my knots aren't breaking at all or anything like that, and working on them. And it actually made it where my knots are stronger. And I've also been working on reading graphs and learning how to read suspended fish and stuff, and determining if it's not just a bunch of clutter that's in the water versus actual fish. And then I've also been working on fishing for suspended fish, because that was one of my rougher areas, but I've gotten way better at it as time has gone for me practicing doing it.
Okay. Well, that kind of brings me into another subject. What do you think a couple of your real strong points are as an angler?
I'm more of a shallow power type of guy. That's just what I've always grown up doing. I'm very good at picking apart docks and figuring out where they are as far as that goes. I'm very good at if they're not eating this, like if they're not eating one thing, I can figure out, okay, this isn't working. What can I do to catch the fish? Like if they're not eating power, I can try skipping a jig or something. Maybe they want that little bit slower presentation, something like that. And just figuring out what to do whenever everything kind of falls apart, if that makes sense.
Absolutely. So, you know, let's transition to the Alabama Bass Nation. I assume that you are a Tiger Division guy. Is that correct, or a Tide?
I think I'm a Tide.
You're a Tide? So you fished up in Wheeler?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you're a Tide guy. So, you know, well, tell me about your experience here on Lake Wheeler this past weekend, then.
Lake Wheeler, it was kind of a grind. We played, like I told you earlier, we played McAdory in double overtime, and it was at home. So I had to go home, go from the game home, shower, load up in the car, make that 2.5-hour drive up to Wheeler, prep everything for the boat, and then that was me. I was in bed at 1:30, and then I rolled over, went to sleep, and woke up at – and then I was up at 4 for the tournament. So it was a grind. We found fish. It was just – there were so many bait fish that we couldn't fin through the bait fish versus our one regular our bait. We caught plenty of fish. It was just – there were a lot of 11.5 inches, 11.75, and it was just – we couldn't really find the right fish, but we know we'll get them in the next one. I mean –
Absolutely. And like I said, you know, Skyler, you weren't the only anglers ever having trouble out there. There was a lot of anglers out there that had the same issue, just a bunch of short fish out there. So, you know, let's talk about your goals for the Alabama Bass Nation this year. Have any goals you want to talk about or that you've set?
Definitely want to go to state. That's like my short-term goal, if that makes sense. Short-term goal, go to state. And then my bigger goal after that will be to go qualify for nationals.
Okay. So, and you know, like I said, it's excellent. So, you know, I want to wrap up the Zoom presentation. So I'm going to give you the platform. Is there anything that you want to discuss or, you know, disclose or tell the coaches about that you may have forgotten about or we may have not spoken about?
Like I said before, I'm very good at staying on top of my priorities. I know one of their concerns is probably going to be the balance between the classroom and fishing team and seeing where my head's at. I can do both. I'm very good in the classroom and I like to say I'm fairly good at fishing. And so I got that balancing act down and just, that's about it.
Okay. You know, Skyler, awesome interview. I thank you for your time. And I, you know, kudos for you following in Kyle's legacy. I hope you achieve that dream. Naturally, getting a college scholarship was going to put you on that path. So I just want to thank you for your time and thank you for sharing your interview with us, and I hope you have a great time at Combine, and congratulations.
Thank you, sir. Thank y'all for setting up the Combine. Don't forget, son, there is someone.